Yes, so hello everyone. I hope I'm audible and my screen is visible to everybody. Okay, so maybe I think today it will be your last session. I think so, because that's what actually I came to know. Okay, maybe possible. If I get some notification, definitely we will have some more sessions, but most probably I think it will be last one, right? So first of all, let me ask you, any doubt, anyone? So if someone is having any doubt, I can unmute that person, no problem. Anyone, any doubt in general, till now whatever we have discussed, right? So about any topic, if you want to ask me about any topic from this one, right, as per your syllabus, or maybe in general any doubt, maybe for the assignment which I have shared today, because some of you have actually there were some people who are sending the messages that they have some doubt, right? So here we are, you can ask actually. Any doubt anyone regarding any point from this one, or maybe whatever you have discussed till now, or doubt in the assignment which I have shared today? Yes, anyone in doubt? Because if that is clear, then I will go on and discuss this visualizations part and then complete it. Tableau actually what I have done is, Sharon, in case of Tableau, the PDF file which I have provided to you, in that PDF almost whatever I have discussed is already given in that. I don't think so you will require a revision kind of a thing for Tableau actually, because what I have shown in case of Tableau is Excel data analysis, and the same thing I have shown in Tableau. So everything is actually mentioned in the PDF itself. Are you getting here? Yeah. So Anurag is asking, sir, will you recommend taking R programming for next semester? We have option. Yes, you can go for R programming. Right? If you people remember, in one of the sessions, I think I have shown you network diagram kind of a thing. Right? So that was in R program. So see, as you people have already studied, for example, here you studied about data science, right? So R programming can also be one of the tools. Rather, I can say one of the important tools to work on data science. And definitely, it is going to add to your resume itself. If you know R as well as Python, that's always handy. So yes, what was that question? Yes, I will say that R programming, Anurag. Yes, I will recommend that. If you have that, then go for R programming. No doubt about that. And again, you people are already aware about Python. Understanding R will not be a big trouble for you, because many things you will see that in R and Python they are similar. For example, data frames, right? At the time of talking about data frames, even I told you that data frame actually it is a concept which is taken from R and Python. So yes, you can go for it. Yes, anyone want to ask any doubt? I will unmute that person. Just raise your hand. I muted all of you just to not to create a chaos, that's all. But today I can see there are less number of people. 16 people are there. So I can unmute, no problem. If anyone has any question in general, you can ask. Yes, anyone? Okay, are you people clear about all the questions in the assignment which I share? Any doubt about them? I think I share two simple Python programs. One of those Python programs, see, if you, I think, in this one. This is what the assignment which I have shared, right? I hope you people are able to see. The first problem is based on a priori algorithm. Again, it's a very common problem. You might have seen this kind of problem. Or otherwise, the numerical which I have discussed in the sessions, this is something similar to that. Only the data is changed. Otherwise, you need to apply the same steps which I have discussed in this session itself, right? So this problem is there. This is one of the problems. Okay. And yeah, you can see this, you can read this particular problem. I hope you people are able to remember all the things which we have discussed in case of a parallel group. Rajnandini, I did not create the submission link because what has happened is, otherwise, if you people create, if you go and try to submit at one place, so there is actually a storage problem at that place right now. And that's why I asked you people to submit at, to upload at your own end. See, you just need to upload your assignment on your Google Drive and just share the link with me. That's right. There is I will have to update actually. Whatever the storage space was there, that is, I am done with that. That's right. Otherwise, I could have asked you to submit at one place itself. Okay? Because again, it will require some time, then you people also will have to wait. And that's why I thought that, okay, I should ask you people to go and share the link so that I can go to that link and I can just check whether you people have done it or not. Yes. You people can ask me in notes, okay? In between, no problem. Just anything about whatever you are discussing now. So you can see this first question is actually in the assignment. What we have given is this data, customer ID, transaction ID, the basket content, products, right? These are the products. So you need to do what? You need to apply a price algorithm on the drug data set, which is given in the table, with support count, which is given as 4. I hope you remember support count. Then show the candidate and frequent data sets for each iteration. So you need to apply, you need to do all the steps, whatever I have shown you. And then enumerate all the final frequent data sets. Right? So which are the final frequent data sets? Maybe in a group, maybe a single item, right? Depending on the iterations. And also you need to indicate the association rules. This is going to be the last step. You need to find out all the association rules which are possible because of this particular transactions or data that could be generated from the assumptions, and you need to highlight the strongest ones, right? So what is the minimum support you are going to get? According to that, you can go and you can decide which association rules are going to be the strongest ones. I hope you people are clear with this question. Right? Next question is actually dependent on classification. So you people need to decide which algorithm you can go and you can apply. This type of a problem can be solved with multiple algorithms, because we know that for classification we have multiple algorithms. It's not like that a particular algorithm should only be used. Right? You can go and you can make use of any classification algorithm which you can think that okay, it is going to be a good algorithm at this place. Right? So what you need to do here is we have data from questionnaire survey, right, to ask people about some opinion, and objective testing with two attributes, asset durability and the strength of the asset. So to classify whether a special tissue is good or not. Right? So here is 4 training samples which are good. So asset durability and the strength is good. For example, the asset durability is 7 and the strength is 7. It has found out that, it has been found out that the classification is bad. Right? It is classified as in the category of bad. Similarly, then second is bad, good and good. So what you need to do is, now the factory produces a new pair issue that passed laboratory test with xn equal to 3 and x2 equal to 7. So these two input variables are given to you. And then what you need to do is, without another expensive survey, can we guess what classification of this new issue is? So you need to find out under which class this particular record is going to be. Right? With x1 equal to 3 and x2 equal to 7. So you have different options actually. You have KNN algorithm and you have some other algorithms also. Logistic regression is also there, but you need to check at which you can make use of here. Then the third question is, so for the first two questions, what you need to do is you need to write down the answer on the paper. Yeah. Yes, someone has raised hand. Priyansh. Riesh, we have done. Now, Sharan is asking, sir, do we have to use linear regression for question 2? No, it's not compulsory that we can make the linear regression. Linear regression is used for what? linear regression is used for prediction or regression, Sharan. You cannot use linear regression here. It's a classification problem. Are you getting it? It's a classification problem. Your output variable is like categorical variable. So obviously, linear regression is not going to work here, right? Are you getting, Sharan? Linear regression obviously not possible. You need to go for so which algo to use? That's why I said. That's what I said. You have different options. We have seen KNN. KNN, K nearest neighbor, can be used here in this question. And think about, can we use another algorithm, classification algorithm, to solve the problem? Just check it, right? Because even for KNN algorithm also, we have seen some problems. Yeah, linear regression obviously you cannot make use of, because linear regression algorithm is used for prediction or regression. Yes, the person who raised hand, Riyesh, we have it out. Or okay, I think he's gone. He's not there. Okay, third question is, so Python program you need to write up and you need to take the screenshots of the output. So write a program to check whether a number is palindrome or not on following conditions. So this is not a straightforward problem. Try to understand. Someone has asked me, right? He wasn't able to understand the question. So I told you that this is not a straightforward question for checking out whether the number is palindrome or not. Try to understand the question itself. The question is, you need to, first of all, obviously, you need to check whether the number is palindrome or not. If it is palindrome, they just display the answer. But what if it is not palindrome? If it is not palindrome, then you need to apply the same process, or you need to repeat the same process again. Right? For example, let me just show you. Suppose I have maybe I have some number. Suppose, see, it should be like this. I will tell you how your program should function. So your program should ask, enter the number. Right? Enter the number. Now user is going to enter some number. Suppose as a user you have entered 720. Right. Now what should happen at the back end? See, 721 you have entered. What is the reverse of 721? 127. Right. First of all, obviously check 127. Now is 721 and 127 are they same? Obviously not. So your this 721 is not a palindrome. But what I mean to say is, if it is not palindrome, then you need to do this one. Add number and its reverse. So do not check for this as a palindrome directly. First of all, add the number and its reverse. So I reverse it. So what I am getting is this one, 868. Now whatever you got, now reverse this. So yes, this is a palindrome. Then what you need to print is, number is 868. So number is 868 and it's a palindrome. That's it. Suppose you have entered some number for which you do not get palindrome in first step itself. Let's suppose you have entered, let's take any number, or tell me any number for which you are not going to get palindrome very easily. So maybe I think 126. Let me check with 126. See, 126 if I take 621. Right. So what it will be? Okay, again it's a palindrome directly. Let me go with 84, 48. So it is 4. Right. Well, it should be 2. This is 130. So now see, in case of 84, what will happen? Suppose user has entered 84 as a number. Now what should happen? Take the reverse of 84. Take the reverse of 84, that is 48. So what is the addition you are getting? 132. Right? Now is 132 a palindrome? No, it's not a palindrome. So what your program should do is, you should add reverse of 132. So 132 reverse is 321. What are you getting? 3. 5. 3. So in the first step, it did not be palindrome. What you did in that case? Taken the reverse and added that reverse to the original number, and then again check, is the addition of palindrome? Yes, it's a palindrome. So what you should print is, number is 132, reverse is 321, number is 352, and it's a palindrome. So till you get the palindrome, you should print all the numbers and all the reverse, number and its reverse, and see. One time is definitely going to come where you are going to get palindrome, because it has been mathematically proved that If you go on doing like this, definitely you are going to get bankrupt at one place. That's what the problem is. So this problem was actually asked in one of the interviews. Okay. So again, with the help of Python, you can easily do it. Just a logic, right? It is just what I can say. Just clear to think about some logic, and then just you can easily solve. I hope many people might have solved it. Okay. So let's see. Again, there are multiple solutions which are possible. Let's see who will give the best solution for us. I hope everyone is clear about that particular question. Okay. Next question is, write a Python function to find and display a 5-digit number. It use the first digit is 2 more than the second. Just you have been given some condition. That's it. Nothing else in this. Okay, it's a straightforward question. You have to carefully observe the conditions and accordingly display the answer for that. Of course, second digit is 2 more than the fourth digit is 2 less than the third, and the last digit is 2 more than the fourth. Right? The sum of the third and the fourth and the fifth digit equals the first. So you just need to put all the things on the paper and just think about it. Okay. These are just a simple condition. So only 4 questions I have given in the assignment. I hope everyone is pretty much clear with all the questions. So I will again ask you, any doubt anyone? Is it clear everyone? How to submit your assignments? Just let me know. See, I don't know whether it will be another session or not. Just let me know if you have any doubt regarding this subject or whatever you want to ask, you can answer. No? Okay. I'll be sharing. See, I think I told you at the start itself, right? We people are in training as well as in development, right? So if some of you are interested to work in deep learning or artificial intelligence or machine learning or data science, or natural language processing, or data analytics, business analytics, in the fields like that. Right? So definitely, I'll be sharing some notifications regarding that. Because what we do is we provide some internships and sponsorships. So those who are really interested to work, definitely I will be assigning some tasks. Right. So maybe as you people can give the reference from your college. Definitely, if you are interested to work, definitely there are. You can approach me anytime, no problem. Okay. So just related to that and related to some tasks, definitely I'll be sharing some documents in your WhatsApp. For Monday practical, yes. That's what I'm saying. So most probably it will be last session. Today will be last session. Yes, sure. Okay, I think no one is having any question, so let me then continue with some data visualization part, which was remaining from the C1 package. So at least we'll be able to do the C1. See, whatever I want to discuss about this particular unit, I have discussed that. Regarding fourth unit, we are done with all the contents. If you see from the first unit itself, right? And we have conducted one online test also. So just maybe in your panel exam also, you'll be able to see similar kind of questions based on data visualization, questions based on SVM, KNN, right, linear regression, logistic regression, upper IV algorithm. All those questions definitely will be able to see. So one should be clear about the concepts which we have discussed. Based on the concepts only, you are going to see the questions in your exam. Right? And obviously, if you have any doubt, definitely you can go and you can refer the video recordings which I have already shared. Remaining video recordings I'll be sharing, definitely. If you are interested, I'll be sharing it as soon as possible. But if you think that you do not know the recordings, you do not need the recordings, then no problem. Okay, I will also not share, because I can see if you are able to understand the things here itself, then maybe I will not upload it. But yeah, if some people ask, definitely I will be uploading the remaining recordings also. Okay, this was just for you people. Okay, because I know that some of you might not be able to attend the session, some people attend the session late, and so on. That's what that is only. Okay, so I hope then no one is having any doubt about regarding the assignments and how to submit, and no one is having any doubt about all these points, right? So okay, maybe study all the points. Let me know if you have any doubt in between. Also, you can ask the questions. You already have my contact number, right? You can ask me question anytime. Okay. So if you do not have any question. Okay, Shamak is asking, sir, could you please tell us how to prepare for subjective exam? So, in case of subjective exam, you will see this kind of questions. This is your preparation for subject exam. That's why I shared the assignment here. Is it clear? The person who asked a question about subjective exam. So, this kind of questions. Similar kind of questions you are going to see in your subjective exam. Objective also you are again very much familiar, right? Yeah. Okay, so I will take it like, see, if you people do not have doubt, that means you have understood everything. That is first, what you can say, first possibility. Second is that you don't have, you haven't understood anything. So you decide in which category you people are. I hope most of you have learned something in those days, right? And yeah, at that point, just let me know if you have any doubt related to this. You can approach me. So let's continue. Let's complete this part from the C1. At least as we have some time, definitely we go on to this. So see, we were talking about distribution plots. Categorical plots, right? We have seen. Let's see about this one. Matrix plots, grids, regression, style and curve. Right. So let's try to discuss about this one. Let me check whether we have discussed all the categorical plots or not, and then move to the matrix plots. So C1 basically is used for visualization only. That is a good option to make use of. But generally, what happens is, we people also try to do visualization or data preprocessing before creating any model. We actually make use of a mixture of Matplotlib and C1. So it's not like that we use only C1. So Matplotlib, you might be knowing that Matplotlib is a very basic package for visualization. Generally, we actually try to make use of a mix of both Matplotlib as well as C1. And as I told you many times that it's not like that there is only Matplotlib and C1. There are other packages also which are available in Python for data visualization. Even with the help of R, you can go and you can do good data visualization. There are good packages which are available in R for data visualization. But more or less, you will find out that the graphs or the charts which are available, more or less they are same. For example, if you talk about something like a box and whisker plot. So box and whisker plot, you can go and you can plot it in R languages, right? And initially, I think we talked about R, right? Yeah, I have shown you, right? I introduced you to R also, right? So, but yes, R also can do a lot of things because of the packages. But let me tell you, most of the times, who are going to make the R is the people who are related to statistics background. It doesn't mean that the people who are related to programming background, they do not make the R. But yeah, that is the scenario. Both of them, they are good, whether it's Python or R. If you people are having some subject in the next semester which is related to R, definitely it will be like some add-on in this field actually, AI or data science, machine learning, deep learning, right? So yes, even with the help of R, we can do data visualization. So yesterday, I think we were talking about all this. I told you that we are going to discuss on these plots. So let me talk about some of these plots. Yeah, factor plot is there. See, factor plot, box plot, wiring plot, state plot, swarm plot. And yes, I told you that out of these things, most of the times we make use of this bar plot, we make use of box plot, we make use of and count plot. Even though there are a lot of other graphs which are mentioned here, but it has been observed that what we need is these things: box plot, bar plot, count plot kind of things. So let's see the one by one actually. Let me go on with the here. and let's try to discuss that. Box and whisker plot, if you remember, I think we have discussed it in R also. So C1 package, first of all, let me input. So input C1 with SNS. So here you can see that the data set which I am trying to make you know, it is the data set which we already used in the last session, right? TIBS. TIBS data set is a data set which is by default present in C1. Because of the C1, we can actually load it. So same thing I am going to do here. I'm going to load it and display the first one. So total will be TIBS sets mobile day. And so one example at least we will try to talk about bar plot and count plot. You can see here similar kind of plot we have discussed. Right? Bar plot is a general plot that allows you to aggregate the categorical data based on some function. So something like this you are going to get x and y axis. This is what we have seen, right? You can plot bar plot like this. Here, this one also I have shown you. Right, estimator in case of bar plot. These things I think, yeah, these things will be completely estimated. Count plot is there. Box plot, if you remember, I told you. Regarding box plot, this is nothing but what? This is the minimum value. This is 25 percentile. This is 50 percentile. This shows 75 percentile. And this is the maximum value. So, minimum value or nothing but 0%. Maximum value is nothing but what? 100%. 25% is what? It is called as quartile 1. This is called as quartile 2. This is called as quartile 3. So, box plot. Where it actually helps us? Box plot helps us to know about outliers. For example, see, these are the outliers. These are the outliers. In our case, in this TIBS data set, in this TIBS data set, these are the outliers. Right? If you are able to see, for example, you can check it. The value which is greater than 40, right? These are the outlier values. In case of Saturday, in case of Sunday, and so Thursday and Friday, you can check it. Values greater than 30 are considered as outlier values. So these are actually the values of total value. And yes, we have already discussed, right? What do you mean by outlier value? So out of all this plot, this box and whisker plot is something important, which gives us a lot of idea before going for development. Right. For example, see, SNS or box plot, x axis I want day, y axis total bin, data is what? TIBS and palette. In it, this is just a color scheme, you can say. And if I go and if I try to run it, I'll be able to see something like this. Now, how you can interpret, for example, if here you can see that, I think this is the thing which I was trying to explain you in the last session itself. Right? So, for example, if you consider Saturday. Now, on Saturday, suppose this value, if you consider this value is 25%. Just suppose it is maybe it's 15, right? So this value is 15 on Saturday. Now, what do you mean by that? So I told you this value is nothing but what? This is actually quartile 1, or we can call it as 25%. So 25% of total bill, 25% of total bill on Saturday is 15. What is the meaning of that? It means that 25% of the total values, 25% of the total values from total bill column are having value less than or equal to 15. So I think we have 244 values total. So 25% of the 244 values are less than or equal to 15. That is the meaning of this percentile. Similarly, you can go for 50%, 70%, and so on. I hope you people have got the meaning of percentile. Those who are already aware about it, no problem. But I'm just trying to talk about the people who are not aware about it. Orient is just an option with the help of which you can go and you can just change this orientation. Okay, like this. And yes, you have a lot of options available in box plot. U parameter, right? You are already aware about U parameter. U is used actually for categorical data, right? So we can make use of different parameters in our dataset. For example, this is in our dataset. We know that we have these columns, right? We have total field time, date, then sex, smoker, date, time, size. All these things we have. So out of all these things, U parameter here it is given as smoker. So whether the person is smoker or not, yes or no. So yes, we can go and we can change the U parameter. Now see, you can see the data in more detail with the help of this U parameter. So for example, if I want to interpret this particular diagram, so yes, there are a number of interpretations which you can draw from this particular box plot. For example, just take an example of Sunday. So on Sunday, who prefer visiting the restaurant? So you can see this is smoker and this is non-smoker. So on Sunday, it has been seen that smoker prefer more visiting the restaurant as compared to non-smoker. On Saturday, same case. Right? But on Friday, you can see that non-smokers are more as compared to smokers. And again, on Thursday, almost they are same. Right? This is what the scenario is. And yes, if you go and if you try to check, maximum bill generated by smokers is more. In case of whether it's a Saturday, Sunday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, maximum bill is generated by smokers as compared to non-smokers. And like this, you can have a number of interpretations from this box of this person, or generally it is called as box plot. So this palette is nothing but just a color scheme, I can see. I think this set is not working. Let me try it for rainbow, something like rainbow. Again, you have a lot of options here. See, rainbow is something like this. You can check it. Again, this is a box and whisker plot. So out of all these things, I hope if you, maybe you will come across box and whisker plot in R programming also. Definitely. When you will start with your that new subject, you will go for that subject. And definitely, you will see that this box and whisker plot is being used there. Okay, so that is box and whisker plot. Let's talk about violin plot. So we can see a violin plot plays a very a similar role as box and whisker plot. But yes, there are some limitations to violin plot actually. That's why you will not see people making use of violin. Because box and whisker plot does most of the things which violin plot can do. So violin plot shows the distribution of quantitative data across several levels of categorical variables, such as those distributions can be compared. Unlike a box plot, in which all of the plot components correspond to actual data points, violin plot features kernel density estimation, underlying the distribution. That means it shows you the distribution also. Right, see. Let me show you a violin plot here. See, if I go and if I try to plot a violin plot, definitely we will be able to see that. So just check, we are trying to plot a violin plot between day and total bill. Now we know that day is a categorical column and total bill is like a continuous column. So SNS.violin plot is the method which you make use of. Cbound.violin plot is the method which you make use of for plotting a violin plot. Here we have x-axis, y-axis, this is our data, and palette, that's what we have used, right? So here if I go, now what violin plot can show is, you can see on x-axis I have day and y, so total bill is there. Yes, it is showing that on Saturday is the day on which highest total bill is being generated. But you are able to see something like this one also. So what we mean by this, this is the distribution of it. That means, see, in this range, between $10 to $20. So this is the range where the distribution is more. That means most of the people, they prefer or they generated most of the bills between $10 and $20 a week. Most of them. There are very few people who generated the bill near to 40 or 50. Very few people. You can see this. But this one is very big one, right? This is the largest size here, you can see it. So for which number it is, it is in between the range of 10 to 12 or 10 to 15, you can see. Right? So this is the range where most of the people generate the bill. And the number is maybe $10 to $15 you can see for us, or $10 to $20 you can see. Right? So, violin plot actually shows you the distribution also. But the disadvantage is what? Suppose if the distribution is more, then what might happen is this might touch one another. These two things might touch one another. And then there will be overlapping and all those things. And that will not be good for visualization. That can be a disadvantage. But yes, there are some options with the help of which we can at least minimize those things. For example, something like this. What am I doing here is, I am making use of a view parameter, right? So again, view parameter, you can actually use a any other categorical variable you can make use of. Suppose u is equal to, let me go for a time, lunch or dinner. Suppose if I go and try to check, now see, you can check it that for lunch and dinner. So on Thursday, see, one more point, one more most of the important point you can notice is that on Thursday people prefer only lunch, no dinner. Very few people are there, right? Actually only one who went for dinner on Thursday. On Friday, yes, near about same, because people came to the restaurant, right? And as from the volume plot, you can see that many people they prefer dinner itself. Saturday only dinner, Sunday only dinner, right? So one point we can notice that on holidays people prefer visiting the restaurant at the time of dinner only. This is one point we can notice. If you want to go and if you want to make use of some other categorical variable, that's what you can make use of. See, again, you can check it. So who generated the more bill? You can see that, right? Here, because of this few parameters, we are able to see this kind of a graph. Okay, that's what is possible in case of variable. Again, there are different options also. For example, we have something like this. So as I told you that there might be, like, suppose if these variables go on increasing, then there might be like overlapping of the graphs, variables, right? So what we can make use of is, just to make use of that particular space, we can just write down split is equal to 2, something like this. So what's going to happen is, this graph is going to take less space. That means these two things are going to be combined. Then if you use view parameter, see, something like this you'll be able to see. Now see, you can check it, male and female. So something like this we'll be able to see. So instead of the earlier graph, now it is less space, right? So there will be less chance of overlapping, right? Even if the data is bigger. So yes, you can make use of something like split, which is available in case of while input. Then let's try to talk about strip plot and swarm plot. So the strip plot will draw a scatter plot where one variable is categorical. This is something important. Right, one variable is categorical. Okay? A strip plot can be drawn on its own, but it is also a good complement to a box or violin plot in cases where you want to show all observations along with some representation of the underlying distribution. So all observations means all rows you want to show. Right, in that case you can make use of this one, strip plot. So swarm plot is similar to strip plot, but the points are adjusted only along categorical axis, so they don't overlap. This gives a better representation of distributions of values, although it does not scale as well as to large numbers of observations. Right? Let's see. Let's try to plot both of them. Let's see strip plot first. This is a simple example of a strip plot. SNL dot strip plot is the method which we make use of. X-axis, y-axis. You can see this. X-axis is categorical data. Y-axis is numerical. This is what my data is. Let's go and let's try to plot a strip plot for this. So see, it actually plots a scatter plot. But what is the difference between the previous one and this one? If you want to show all the observations, each marker is actually a observation, a row in the data set. And that's what you can do with the help of strip plot. Now why to go and why to worry about these observations? Because it also tells you about the number of records or the distribution in the data. So here it is, definitely it is showing me the relationship between the day and the total day. Yes, definitely we can actually interpret number of things here. For example, we can say that okay, Saturday and Sunday are the days which most of the people prefer visiting the restaurant, and so on. But you can see that if this data go on increasing, if there are a lot of observations, if there are a lot of records in your data set, so there will be more overlap. Right, like this. There's an overlap here. There's an overlap here. So we can actually try to minimize that overlap. See, there are a lot of overlap here. Suppose there's an overlap here itself. There's an overlap here itself. What if we want to separate those points, or we want those points to be at some distance from each other, so that we will be able to see at least most of the data points. Right. So yes, that kind of a thing is possible in case of a strip plot, and we can make use of an option called as jitter, right? So if I go and if I try to make jitter equal to true, I'll be able to see same graph, right? Otherwise, let me go and let me try to write down this particular thing separately so that you will be able to compare the graphs of the plots. Now see, you will be able to see something like this. So what has happened here actually in case of, okay, let me make it as first of all, let me make it as false and then run. Now see, what are you able to see? Something like this. There was a huge overlap. Now in jitter equal to false. But if I go with jitter equal to true, because in my case it was true itself. Because maybe last time when I run this particular command, so I made it as true. Now see, when I made jitter equal to true, now I am getting this kind of a strip plot. Otherwise, if jitter is false, you will get something like this. At overlap. So you can make the jitter equal to false when you have a lot of observations in your data, and maybe if you do not want overlap, you can go with this jitter equal to false. So yes, this jitter option is also available in case of strip plot. Okay, that is one thing. And yes, you have palette. U parameter is also available in case of this strip plot. Okay, suppose if I go and if I try to show you, maybe based on time, right? Let's say dinner or lunch. So maybe based on time, it's going to show you the details. So lunch or dinner. So you can see that Saturday and Sunday, that is weekdays, people prefer dinner as compared to lunch. On Thursday, people prefer lunch as compared to dinner. But on holidays, people prefer dinner itself. So this kind of a simple interpretation you can make with the help of this diagram, right? And yes, as there is the option always, there is palette, you have different color schemes. Let me check this set one goes over. Now see, set one is showing me something like this. Or we have other color schemes which are available. Something like this, you can make it work, right? So that is a strip plot. I hope you got an idea about strip plot. Then if you are making use of U parameter and you want to split something. See, now what's happening is both, if I am talking about time, so lunch and dinner, they are overlapping each other, right? So maybe let me make it as this one. See, now male and female, they are overlapping each other. What if I want them to be separate? So yes, you can make use of this split. Let's say this one is going to go somewhere. So it has shown me warning, but yes, it has actually done everything, whatever I wanted. I think, yeah, instead of split, now they are using a name called as dodge. So I should make it as a dodge, then it will not show me warning. No need to remember all these things actually. Now see, what is the difference between previous and this one is, now you can see that as per our hue parameter, it has separated the graph on Thursday, separate for male and separate for female. So something like this you can do with the help of a strip plot. Similarly, you have swarm plot. Strip plot and swarm plot, both of them, they actually give near about same information, right? So that's why I said generally most of the times you will not see people making use of these graphs, but yeah, in some situations definitely you can think about it. Swarm plot, again, it is going to show distribution also, and it is going to show the count also, right? So you have all the options in case of swarm plot also, like palette, split is there, view parameter is there, and all these things definitely you can do in the plot. So these are the things which are possible with the help of swarm plot. Again, instead of the split, I should have done it as dots. That is the updated thing in case of CO, and that's why they're showing us this kind of output. This kind of a warning. So again, you can check it this one. Swarm plot. So it is not that much different from earlier graphs. And if you want to go and if you want to combine both of them, swarm plot, wild plot, if you want to combine them, definitely you can, it's possible like this. Plot, wild plot first and then swarm plot, and then you will be able to do something like this. And finally, factor plot is something like where you can plot anything, whatever you want. So in this kind option, I can plot, I can make use of different options. It can be bar, it can be histogram, and number of them. Suppose, let's say it is given as bar, right? So factor plot, I am going to plot x-axis, y-axis given. It is going to show me a bar plot here. So instead of, okay, they are saying that factor plot, they are calling it as cat plot. So instead of factor plot, I should make it a cat plot. Cat plot, and then it will not show me one. Now say this is what you can do. Now here, if I want to check what are the other options that are available for kind, I can go and I can do shift F and by default it is strip, it will not give anything. And here in examples you might be able to see something like different options for the kind option. Let's see, you have different options like point, bar, strip, swarm, box, wiring, box M, all of them there. Let's try to go with point for example instead of this bar. Let's check if it's possible or not. Now see, if I go with point, I am able to see something like this, male and female. So you can go with anything you want. Box in, something like box in is also there. See, something like this you will be able to see. Okay. Again, it is actually talking about the count as well as the distribution. So this is how it works, set, this C1. There are other points also in case of C1. There are other options, there are other plots like matrix plot, grid plots, relation plots, and so on. Okay, definitely. If someone is interested, definitely you can ask me. I will share this all these things with you. If not, no problem. Okay. So I think that's it. That is time. The 25 minutes are done. So yeah, I can ask if anyone any doubt. You can ask me. Those people who join right now. Yes, you can also ask me the doubts if you have any. That's what I asked you initially because initially, I think there were very few people, but some of them they have joined just now. So yeah, if you have any doubt regarding maybe the assignment or maybe whatever we have discussed till now, right? Just you can leave me. Otherwise, I will stop here and you can share your names and your symptoms. Okay, guys.